Let's next take a look at mesh quality. And to do that, I will highlight mesh in the tree. And under statistics, by default, you will see that none is selected. So go here, and you can see there are lots of metrics of mesh quality that you can look at. One that's often looked at is skewness. So let's take a look at that. And it shows me the skewness distribution of my mesh. So the skewness can go from 0 to 1. So I have elements that go from a skewness of 0 to a skewness of about 0.63. And to see the elements that are least skewed, click on this bar here, and Ansys highlights those elements. Let me turn off the ruler here. So I'll say view ruler. So I got rid of the ruler. And if I zoom in here, I can see, and you know, I can manipulate it and look at it, and it's like, oh, okay, these are nice boxy elements. And that these give you the best accuracy. In contrast, let's look at the most skewed elements. And so I'll go and click the bar where, you know, corresponding to the most skewness. And if I zoom in, especially in my region of concern, you can see, you know, those elements are kind of highly are skewed, and that will degrade the accuracy of the interpolation, and particularly the stress distribution that you get in those areas. And to see, you know, what level of skewness to target, let's take a look at the help page on skewness. So go to help, mechanical help, and you can search for skewness. You can see I already did that, and if you hit enter and pick this hit, skewness under global mesh controls. And it brings up a discussion of skewness, and it shows, you know, for a quadrilateral, this is the least skewed, this is a very skewed element. And it says, if you want good elements, you should target a skewness of less than 0.5. And you can look at this page, it has details on, you know, the skewness and so on. So these elements might be elements of concern. And especially when I'm doing the mesh refinement, I need to go and take a closer look at the skewness. And you have settings under Mesh Advanced that you can play with in terms of, you know, in terms of reducing the skewness and so on. So, so let me select all elements. So I can click anywhere away from the bars, and it'll select all elements. Let me pin this. Let me go back to fit to view. Let me get my isometric view and save the project.